Hello, this is Kathleen McKee of Olene's.com Machine Embroidery Art.
Lesson 2, More Tools. In Lesson 1, I showed you how to set up your quick access toolbar so that you would have all your most frequently used tools at your fingertips without having to click on a bunch of different tabs to find what you're looking for. At that time, I reviewed most of the tools briefly, but here are a few more tools that you must understand before you get started. I'm going to start right up here. In the upper right-hand corner, you have these two little boxes. One looks like a little man, and the other says Option. So let's see that little arrow, and let's pull it down and see what you have. You can get to your Design Center, your Programmable Stitch Creator, the Design Database, your Font Creator, your design page settings. You can even edit your settings in your thread with this Options key. Just as important is this little man icon. When you pull that down, you're gonna see your instruction manual. And I'm telling you, this instruction manual is wonderful. Anything you need more explanations on, check it out in the manual. Just type in what you're looking for. Also, check for upgrades. Now, if you haven't ever clicked on that before, make sure you do, and it will tell you if the most recent update for PE Design is already installed. And I check this box to always check for the most recent version at your startup, so I don't have to worry about if I'm running the most recent version. And if you can't remember what version you're running, you can always just go to About, Layout, and Editing, and it will tell you that we are using version 9.3. Another important tool that you must know where it's located. You see in this corner here, it says it's kind of small. In the upper left-hand corner, it says MM for millimeters. When we digitize, we try to always digitize in millimeters. That way we'll know if a stitch is too short, being under a millimeter, or if it's too long, over 7 or 8 millimeters. But sometimes people will say, well, I need a 2-inch design, and I really don't think in inches. So when I do that, I'll click on the MM, and it'll change it to inches. That way, when I use my measure tool, and I click and drag, I'll know, while I'm looking down in this lower left-hand corner, it's gonna tell me how many inches it is. You see how it changes as I move around? So you can use that, and then you can convert right back into millimeters when you're digitizing. And also another thing I wanted to point out to you, that whenever you see a tool that has an arrow, there's a drop down menu with the select tool. Of course, you have your edit and your exit entry tool. In the views, you have a little stitch view here. When you pull that down, you can click on that to view thread trimming, and you'll see little scissors that show you everywhere your machine is going to stop and trim. Now, let me make note that this option is only available if you have a multi-needle machine. When you go to your design settings under home, or if you have it on your quick access toolbar, I have selected the multi-needle machine. But if we click on a single needle machine and say OK, we don't have that option for that drop-down menu. But a lot of these have drop-down menus, the manual punch, the shapes, your fonts, just all of them. Whenever there's a drop-down arrow, check to see what it is, and try them all out so you know all the options that all of your tools have.